Op 4 januari 1986 overleed Phil Lynott. Ooit was hij wereldberoemd met zijn band Thin Lizzy, maar toen hij doodging, verscheen er hier in de krant niet meer dan een klein artikel op pagina 6.
The sadness it never ceases. Oh, I'm still in love with you. In my head, it keeps on reeling.
Wij, Erik en ik, twee fans van het eerste uur, gaan 4 dagen naar Dublin. Op zoek naar de legende. In de hoop een van zijn liedjes te mogen spelen op The Vibe, het herdenkingsconcert dat ieder jaar wordt gehouden op zijn sterfdag. Thin Lizzy heeft vanaf 1970 13 jaar lang bestaan in verschillende formaties. Wij gaan op zoek naar de meest bijzondere bezetting, die magische groep die bestond uit Phil Lynott en Brian Downey, de onafscheidelijke drummer, en Scott Gorham en Brian Robertson, de twee gitaarhelden die met elkaar duelleerden of juist tweestemmig samenspeelden, Thin Lizzy's handelsmerk. Deze bezetting bestond vanaf 1974 tot 1978. Deze mensen proberen we te vinden. En Phil's moeder, Philomena. Zou het daar zijn?
Van
Push. Hello, we're trying to make a film about Phil Lynott.
Right.
Do you know Phil Lynott?
Yeah.
I understood he was from Crumlin.
I'm not sure. I'm not quite sure.
You're not sure?
Where was he from, Lynott?
Okay, listen, go here. Turn left. Down to the roundabout.
Yeah.
Around the roundabout.
And I'm walking home.
Is this Lakeland Road? Now we're looking for the house of Phil Lynott, where Phil Lynott was born.
Where are you from?
Yeah, we're from Holland. We're making a film about. No, it's okay.
Yeah.
No. It's in here.
There.
Where?
Is that your house?
No, well, I'm going to tell me. Where are you from? Holland.
From Holland.
What's she going to do now?
We staan voor het huis waar Phil tot zijn 20ste gewoond heeft. Binnen treffen we tot onze verbazing Timothy en May Lynott aan, zijn oom en tante.
They all from this
they
neighborhood.
Were from, well, three of them from this road.
From Lakeland Road.
Lakeland Road, yeah. They live down towards the end of this.
No. Great.
I think it was him, you know. That was Philip, you know. That was when they were with the Black Eagles, you know.
Don't believe a word. And your heart is like that promise left me broken. Don't believe me if I tell you the word of this is true. Don't believe me if I tell you, especially if I tell you I'm in love with you. Don't believe a word. And I don't believe a word.
The Vibe, het herdenkingsconcert, wordt al 9 jaar lang op 4 januari gehouden. Het wordt georganiseerd door Smiley Bolger.
Right, so it doesn't. Turn out the lights, Derek, would you?
Was it an original one?
That is the original, my friend.
Is this the original?
That is the Live and Dangerous sign.
Was it this small? It's so small.
It was made by the lighting crew and the it's just wood and glass. It's a very basic, simple structure. It's a lot of junk, but at the same time it's art, you know what I mean? It's great.
But how did you get it?
Ah. Now, I've had it.
I've read that U2 also covered, has played Thin Lizzy.
Yeah, we have, in the early days. Well, I think we could do a pretty mean version of Whiskey in the Jar, and I think we did a version of Don't Believe a Word, which was kind of, I don't know when that was a hit, but it must have been 75, 76, and it just seemed appropriate to what was happening in punk at the time.
Don't believe me if I tell you. Not a word if this is true. Don't believe me if I tell you, especially if I tell you I'm in love with you. Don't believe me if I tell you that I wrote this song for you. That's just not just some other silly pretty girl I'm singing to. Don't believe a word, for words are so easily spoken.
Phil had just one of those all-time great voices. He could sing anything. And again, that was kind of at opposites to what was happening in the guitar world at that stage, where you had a lot of screamers. And Lynott was the first one who wrote kind of ballads that meant something, you know. Now they've become an FM format. But when he wrote a ballad, it connected with you. You know, there was a connection. There was those sounds and tones that were part of Irish life. And he must have, you know, he must have got a big blast, you know, an Irish guy, black Irish guy, in Dublin, suddenly realizing that music was a way out and you could look cool and have a career and, you know, get laid and make money. That must have been an amazing kind of drive and excitement for him to kind of go as far as he did.
Oh.
Oh. Ja, als je gewoon de eerste keer speel je het en dan ga je gewoon een patch of zo, of een kwint, volgens mij. En dan ga je naar een octaaf. De derde keer op een octaaf en daartussen ook nog iets. En dan,
ja, dan daartussen ook nog iets.
Bij die octaaf dan eindigt het.
Ja hoor.
Drie keer, ja?
Drie. Jij moet het heel dip. Ja,
drie. Vier.